Hello, dear students. Today I am going to discuss with you the case study based question. This is a case study which is based on the sunroom design. So here you can see that the diagrams show the plans for a sunroom. It will be built onto the wall of a house. The four walls of the sunroom are square clear glass panels. The roof is made using four clear glass panels, trapezium in shape. All of them are of same size. One tinted glass panel, half a regular octagon in shape. Okay, so let us observe here. This is the diagram which is showing the sunroom model. So in this sunroom model, as per the question, you can see that we have four, one, two, three, and here it is four square clear glass panels. And these are basically the four walls of the sunroom. Now observe the roof. As per the question, if you see the roof, so there are four clear glass panels, trapezium in shape. You know what is a trapezium? Here the two sides are parallel and two are non-parallel. So it's a quadrilateral. So it is given that all the trapeziums, they are of same size. Another interesting thing which is given in this sunroom is that the top here, it has one tinted glass panel. Tinted meaning it is colored with some, painted with some color. Okay. So, and the shape is half a regular octagon. So you can very well imagine this shape. One, two, three, four. And this is joined like this. So here, this is the top. Now you see that we are also given the top view. So this is the top view of the sunroom. And the front view of the sunroom is also given to us. So this is the front view. Okay. Also, it is mentioned that this sunroom is not to scale. And if you wish to see this top view and the front view, the scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. This information is given to us. So basically, it is the information about the sunroom and its layout. Now what we are going to do, we will be asked 5 questions in the examination, out of which you need to answer 4. So let us see what different questions have been asked as per the given situation. So the first question is, refer to the top view. So you can now imagine on the top here, there is a tinted glass panel, half regular octagon, and these are the four glass panels which are trapezium in shape. So we have to imagine this. So refer to the top view and find the midpoint of the segment joining point J617. And I916. So let us see, where is this J point? So J is here and I is here. Yes. So here we don't have to refer to this because already the coordinates are given. So we will not waste much of time. And then we will try to think like which formula we have to use for finding the midpoint. So you know that if AX1, Y1, and B, x2, y2 are any two points, then the midpoint is given by x1 plus x2 divided by 2 and y1 plus y2 divided by 2. Right, so we are going to use this and we can simply do the calculations, quick calculations. So you don't have to write also, you can do it in mind. 6 plus 9 divided by 2, that gives us 15 by 2. And quickly you can choose that third part is the right answer. 17 plus 16 divided by 2 is 33 by 2. So the answer to the A part is the third one. Right, so here we have used the midpoint formula. Moving on to the next question. Here also it is saying refer to the top view. The distance of the point P from the y-axis. So now you have to use the maths concept here. How do you find the distance of a given point from the y-axis or from the x-axis? You have to recall that particular concept. And when we say distance of a point from the y-axis or from the x-axis, that means we are talking about the perpendicular distance. So here we can clearly see from the diagram which has been provided to us, this point P has the coordinate 4, 8. And we know that if a point is xy, then abscissa, that is x, denotes the distance of the point from the y-axis, and the ordinate denotes the distance of the point from the x-axis. I hope it is clear to you. So here, if you see the point P, it is at a distance of 4 units from the y-axis. So we can directly see this first part is the right answer. I hope it is clear to you. Okay, moving on to next. Refer to the front view. And here we need to see the distance between the point A and S. Very nice. So here you might be thinking, okay, we need to first find what is A. So you can see the coordinates of A are 1, 8. Similarly, we can find the coordinates of point S, but there is no need of doing so because you can see here it is drawn on the graph and we can simply count like what is the distance between the points A and S. So we can save our time over here. And then we see here that 16 units are there between A and S. So quickly we can choose the answer. Or in case if it is like a slanting line and we are given two points, then in that case you can apply the distance formula. Okay, moving on to next. Find the coordinates of the point which divides the line segment joining the point A and B in the ratio 1:3 internally. So now you tell me which formula you are going to use here. In every situation, you have to think like which mathematical formula or which mathematical result or anything which you have studied, you can apply in solving the question which has been given as per the given case study. So here we can clearly see that in this situation, we are going to use the section formula. Because in section formula, such a situation is provided and we can find the coordinates of a point which divides the line segment in the specific ratio. Here it is given internally. So here you see we have taken the points A, 1, 8 and B, 5, 10. You can simply get the coordinates of the point A and B from the graph which is provided. So we imagine that let P x, y be the point, or you can take Q x, y be the point, or T x, y be the point. So we can find the ordinate and we can find the abscissa using the section formula. So we see that here the x coordinate of the required point will be 1 into 5 plus 3 into 1 upon 1 plus 3. So that is 8 upon 4. It gives us 2. Similarly, y will be equal to 1 into 10 plus 3 into 8 upon 1 plus 3. We can simplify and we get 34 by 4. And that gives us the answer. And we can see that fourth part is here giving the answer, required answer, 28.5. Moving on to next, we need to again refer to the front view. Here it is given, if a point XY is equidistant from Q 9,8 and S 17,8, then we need to see which equation will work out. So here also you have to apply the concept which you have studied in your math class. So you imagine that XY is equidistant from Q 9,8 and S 17,8. Please, in this particular question, remember it's not the midpoint necessary. So here we have to use the concept of distance formula. So we imagine that XY is a point equidistant from 9,8 and 17,8. So we are going to find out the distance. So we get square root of X minus 9 square plus Y minus 8 square is equal to square root of X minus 17 square plus Y minus 8 square. So now we do the squaring both the sides. We can remove the square root sign. And here, interestingly, we notice that we can cancel out Y minus 8 whole square from both the sides. And then we are left with X minus 9 whole square is equal to X minus 17 whole square. So that means X minus 9 will be equal to plus minus X minus 17. Now here two situations are coming. Either X minus 9 is equal to X minus 17. So we are going to reject this. And then the second situation is X minus 9 is equal to minus of X minus 17. So you just simplify this. You get X minus 9 is equal to minus X plus 17. So that gives us 2X is equal to 26. So X is 13. So that means we get the equation X minus 13 equal to 0. So what is the choice? Yes, it is the second choice which is given in this question. X minus 13 is equal to 0. I hope this first case study is clear to you. So now I will be discussing the next case study in my next video. So till then, just practice the questions which are based on the geometrical shapes and some, you know, scale factor is given if they are drawn on a graph paper. So here the knowledge of coordinate geometry is utilized for solving the questions. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.